Good day to you viewers, the Colonel speaking to you live from the Grange, British Imperial YouTube Broadcasting. Today we've got a Columbia FP1597, keeping a stiff upper. Humorous monologue by Oliver Wakefield, the voice of inexperience. Here we go, viewers.
Ladies and men, women and those of you who let conscience be your must realize that while you go about your everyday absolutely carefree without a thought for the future, that the past will creep up on you and without a word of knock the chip off you. Because whenever I look back at the future, it makes me wonder what the past will be like in the... And if you wouldn't mind, frightfully, I should like to transport you, to take you back to dear old, to show you the glamour of your hysterical past. Because whenever I look back on those days, it helps me to keep a stiff upper lip. And I think you should all keep a stiff upper lip, because I think a stiff upper played a splendid part in the making of this great... Because look at the great men who at one time or another have been down on their stiff upper, because, you know, I get on frightfully well with self-made men. In America, all the men are self-made, and all the women are on the make, the sort of tit-foot and vice, and I want you to cast what little mind you have back to the first period, where everything was in a state of, and people were grasping there, because Cromwell and his band of iron head around backs from the Wars of the Roses he came, laying the country waste, tooting, looting and pillaging as he went from the village to village, collecting arms, legs, and anything he could lay his hands on. And as you can imagine, things had come to a pretty pass. And, of course, the prettier the thing, the bigger the... what patriots they were in those days. They laid down their lives before their friends and thought nothing of it. You know, those undoubtedly were the days. The glorious days of the old Regency were when pomp depended on your circumstances and Nell Gwyn was the pride of old Drury. And now let us pass lightly over the next 300 or 400 and try, if you can, to picture yourself a knight with King Arthur on a round table. Of course, I once spent a night on a billiard. Not quite the same thing, perhaps, but probably equally as and of course, I don't want to let my personal discomfort influence you, and this Arthur business is probably all on the up, and I mean, after all, he's buttered his billiard table, he's got a lie in it, you know, and I can't help recalling at this time the words of Nelson at Victoria, chairing Waterloo, when he said, "Up, guards, and don't shoot till you see the whites of there," and you know that the thing that confuses me most in English history is whether Henry the Seventh had 8 wives, or whether Henry VIII had 7, or whether Henry Hall was responsible for the whole business. And as this is something I'll probably never find out, I think I'll rest on my laurels and leave all the Henrys to rest on theirs.
Oh, there we are, viewers. Some amusement value there, I think. Thank you, and goodbye.